It's time for us to listen to the keynote address. And the keynote address will be given to us by the man I call the father of Christians in Lagos State. He's a father because the body, the governing body or the supervisory body of Christians, which is the Christian Association of Nigeria, he is the chairman of the Lagos State chapter of Christian Association of Nigeria. Please, let's welcome Bishop Stephen Adegbite. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you very much. Please be seated. First and foremost, I'd like to give immortal praise to the name of the Lord, who has given us grace to be alive today and also to be a part of this wonderful program. When my brother approached me about the program and I saw his tenacity, I saw his dedication, and I saw his commitment, I promised him I'm going to be here. If there is anything we can do in our generation, is to ensure that we provide the enabling environment for our people to be liberated. And if we fail to do that, then we are failing our responsibility as leaders in our society. When he told me the mission and vision of this magazine and their organization, is what the church must do and support, because we believe in holistic ministry. Like talking about the security that have been mentioned by a brother the other time, talking about looking for how to assist other people and how to be somebody that they can rely on for strength, both spiritually and materially, we must be able to know that we are on earth for a purpose. And if our life is only for us and our family members, then we still need more prayers. We must liberate people, and we must support people, and we must assist the needy. And in the scripture, it was asked, who is my neighbor? And Christ decided not to give a straight answer. Instead, he gave a scenario of somebody traveling from Jericho to Jerusalem and attacked by robbers. And religious people looked the other side, but somebody came from Samaria and gave an helping hand. And he asked the people, who was the neighbor to the victim? Of course, the man that assisted. And he said, go and do likewise. So for us in the body of Christ today in Nigeria, we are preaching that to everyone. And as the director for National Issue and Social Welfare for CAN in Nigeria, and also the chairman for CAN in Lagos State, I also double as the chairman for Christian Council of Nigeria in the entire Southwest and Kwara States. We have made it a responsibility to see that we have a better Nigeria, and Nigerians must be secure. And in doing that is not an easy task. Like people have said, we've extended out of fellowship even to people and to areas that you may not believe that we would dare to visit. Just 2 weeks ago, I was part of the team of the president of CAN that visited Sokoto State and Kebbi State to go and identify with the governments of those states to pray for everyone, not only Christian, that are undergoing all this trouble that we are experiencing as far as insecurity is concerned in our nation. And we're at the palace of the Sultan. We went to Kebbi State, we visited the Emir, and we travel in the night. People will not believe that. We came back to Sokoto from Kebbi at about 9:30 in the night. But God protected us because we were doing his work. And I remember 2 years ago when we went to Adamawa, we went to Taraba, we went to Yola. And when we were going from Adamawa to Taraba, there was no flight. So we had to travel by road. And the can of Adamawa State gave us a bus, brand new bus, but with the inscription of the name of the association on it. So as we were going, the bus developed problem, and the bus refused to move again. And I said to the president, God does not want us to be in this bus. Let us enter their home, small cabs. And we took about four. And we moved on that road for 3.5 hours. And we got to Taraba. We were discussing with Christian Association of Nigeria in Taraba State, and we got information that indeed the Boko Haram laid ambush for us. They were aware of our coming, and they wanted to ambush us on the way. But God delivered us. And when they were unable to see our bus coming anymore in the night, they came to the main road and killed 31 people. That is the country we are in. And many other things that happened, what we have decided is to tell the government the truth at all times. I've never been to Aso Rock before, but because of my position now, I've entered the place about 3 or 4 times. And the day I spoke to the president of our country, he will not forget that day. But there was one occasion, I held his hand and I was asking him, are you sure you are the real Buhari? And he looked at my face. He said, Bishop, you can see now. I said, no. The only thing that will make me to believe you are the real Buhari is because of this thing in your cheeks. But let me tell you something. That was when he was trying to come back. I said, God has given you opportunity to be president, head of state twice now. You are coming for the third time and the final time. You will never have the opportunity again. But Nigerians are suffering. People are in pain. If you don't do anything good for the last time, God will ask you. And everyone surrounding him were just looking at me. And I said, know that one day you will give account of your stewardship. And people thought we will not leave Aso Rock. I said, they know born there. The people knew we have entered this place. So they must allow us to go. They may not allow us to come back home, but this one, we have come. So for Christian Association of Nigeria, we will continue to support any people-oriented programs, anything that will bring joy, peace to the life of the people. Very soon, Advent is coming to commemorate and celebrate the coming, the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And the best gift to the world is Jesus Christ. And the name is Prince of Peace. And in Romans chapter 12, verse 18, if it is possible, live in peace with all men. So, whether you are Muslim, whether you are Christian, as far as we are concerned, you are our brother and our sister. But we demand equality. We demand good governance. We demand healthy environments. We demand good education for our children. We demand good road to be used for our people. And we demand justice and equity. If we're able to get all this, there is no reason why we should fight. And there is no reason why we cannot be at peace with our people. But we travel abroad, we see how things have been done. Nobody tell you to fall in. Immediately you leave the shores of Nigeria and you land in another airport. But the madness comes back when you land at Murtala International Airport or anywhere in Nigeria. They welcome you back with a lot of disorganizations. But we should demand a better environment. That is what this magazine stands for. That is what this organization stands for. And that is what Christian Association of Nigeria stands for. And we will continue to ensure that all these are what we will support every time. And we can also assure you, as your representative, as the voice of the voiceless, the privilege God has given to us to see them one-on-one, to talk to them that you may not be able to have opportunity, we are not going to disappoint God, which is the most important thing. I will not disappoint you. Because our time on earth is very limited and it's very short. What we think is big is more. It's not. Any of us that live, we say, oh, it stay a long time on earth, maybe 100 years. And at 100, you are no longer yourself. When they say good morning, you are saying good evening. The ears have gone. The eyes cannot see properly anymore. You cannot walk anymore. That is old age, Abi. But in God's standard, you are not yet one day. Because in Psalms number 90, he says 1,000 years is like a watch in the night. The meaning of a watch in the night is half a day. It's not a full day. And nobody has lived for one day in the presence of God. Not even Methuselah. He only lived for 968 or 69. And it's not one day. So why were you not now prepared for where you will stay and you spend your eternity? And everything that we have here, we hence here, they are ephemera. But what name we must stand for? Jesus commanded, occupy until I call. So it is our duty to dominate the earth. Because everything has been created for us and for our use and for our own glory. And the moment we believe and we trust in him, we will possess our possession. And we will take what belongs to us. And nobody, like what the devil says to Christ, after Christ defeated him in the first temptation, you remember? He asked Christ, turn the bread to the stone to bread. He should be hungry by now. And Jesus said, man will not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded from the mouth of God. And the devil wrote on the scoreboard, 1-0. He now took Christ to the pinnacle of the church, the temple. Look at the whole world. If you can only bow down for me, I will give everything to you. What an insult. Telling the owner that you want to give him what belongs to him. But most of us, children of God, we don't know what is our own. We don't know our own rights. And like what people have been saying to us, if you know the secret of God's blessing, you will know that every other thing will follow. And I said that to you in the scripture. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And every other thing, mind you, it did not say some other things. It did not say 99 of other things, percent. Every other thing shall follow. Once you have Christ, fame will follow you. Wealth will locate you. Long life will be your portion. So what people call miracle, you are already a miracle. And your life must believe in that. So I congratulate the organizers, especially our brother. And we pray that as many people are joining us online, the blessing of today will be yours. The joy of today will be yours. And eternity will not elude any of you. And I pray that the grace of God will be sufficient for you, both now and forevermore. Shalom. God bless you.